All right, come coffee. I get a cup of coffee.
Fire church on the corner of School and Racine, you know it?
I know School and Racine. So, how are you good people this morning?
Ah, wonderful.
Couldn't be better, and you?
Fine. I'm a little tired.
Oh, been working long?
I just started.
Well, some weather we're having, eh?
Uh-huh. And the weatherman says it's gonna get colder.
Is that so?
Uh-huh.
Well.
Say, are you people going to church this morning?
Yes, we are.
It's Thursday.
That's right.
It's 6:30 in the morning.
Yes?
Well, nothing.
Well, every day's a good day for church.
Uh-huh.
And we like to go before work.
Ah, well.
Do you like to go to church?
Me? No.
Oh, that's too bad. Well, you can come with us if you'd like.
Oh, hey, I appreciate the offer, but I gotta work. You know how it is.
Oh, I know how it is. Some things are more important than work, however.
Like your immortal soul?
Ah, you got me there.
Whether you're going to spend the rest of eternity in a fiery pit, where there is weeping and wailing and gnashing of teeth.
Boy, I really hate that gnashing of teeth.
Oh, Jesus Christ is the most important thing in life. He comes before work, before family.
He is family.
God the Father.
Well, hey, it must be nice to be so well connected.
Oh, you can't imagine the peace that our Lord offers us.
Well, that's just great.
Oh, you just couldn't imagine.
You should see our children, little angels. Lauren was saved when she was 6, and Paula was saved when she was only 4.
I'm very happy for you.
My husband says that they're little angels, and, well, they are most of the time, but they're children. You know how children
are. Sure.
They have been known to misbehave a time or two.
Oh, but when they do, we just spank their little bottoms. Don't we, dear?
You have to have discipline. You just have to.
So we just spank their little bottoms.
Not too hard, though.
Oh, no, not too hard. Just enough to make it hurt.
That's 270. Oh.
We can make the light.
Come on, come on.
We can make the light!
No, we can't.
Why do you drive your cab so slow? You're the slowest cab driver I've ever seen.
Right. Like, I want to get in an accident so you can get to work on time.
I am late as it is, and you're going to make me later, Buster.
Hey, is that my fault? You should have left early.
You'll never make any money if you always go this slow. You've got to be quick. Always be ahead of the other guy.
What do you know about it?
I drive cab on weekend. I have driven cab for 18 years.
Yeah?
Please, the light is green.
Look. Well, that's great.
I can tell you I've not driven cab for very long.
Hey, 4 months?
I would have thought less. Please don't make turn here on Lincoln. It is quicker, much quicker.
Hey, you know, that's a major problem I have with this job, dealing with the other cab drivers. You guys drive like maniacs.
I may drive like a maniac, but at the end of the night, I have more money than you. I have $300 and you have a measly $150. Because I am more aggressive.
Hey, I'll take less money. I don't need the aggravation.
You really sound like a beginner. You will learn. Someday, you will drive as I do.
You know, my passengers, they complain all the time about the way the other cab drivers drive. How, like, when they get in the car, they gotta hold on for dear life and pray they don't get killed on the way.
Who cares how they feel?
Right.
Look, all I'm saying is what I do is my business. And what you do is yours.
Yeah, right. But with that way of thinking, how do you think things are ever going to change, huh? Don't you see what you're doing, man? You're segregating your own people.
Oh, that's bullshit.
Hey, Al.
Hey.
Mind moving any?
No, not yet. Will be, though. Doorman says there's a lot of checkouts today, over 300.
We ain't moved yet, though.
Well, it's a little early now.
It's not that early, man.
Well, I figure we got about 20 minutes, probably.
Well, not everybody's going to be checking out at 8 o'clock.
Well, not everybody who's checking out's going to the airport, either.
Why don't you tell me something I don't know?
All right. Let's ask this guy, huh? You pick up black people?
Yeah.
You hear that? This guy picks up black people. I pick up black
Jesus
people.
Christ, I feel like standing up and saluting the goddamn flag.
Well, so what's your problem,
this
huh?
This is free country.
No, really, man, what's your problem?
Who you guys pick up ain't got nothing to do with me.
Oh, man, listen to yourself. All right, what's with that hat then, huh? That X hat, what's that all about?
Malcolm X.
Oh, you a big fan of Malcolm X?
I read that book.
All right, so, tell me what that means to you.
What do you mean, what it means?
I mean, what does that mean to you?
Black pride, black power.
All right, so what do you think Malcolm X would be saying about you not picking up your own people,
Malcolm
huh?
X don't drive this cab. Malcolm X don't feed my wife and kids, and if he was alive today, I doubt very seriously if Malcolm X would tell me to pick up somebody I don't want to pick up. And don't you act like I'm the only driver out here that's like that, neither. Because there are a lot of drivers don't pick up black folks, especially white drivers.
Man, but don't you see the point?
That's my decision. You and this bald-headed motherfucker want to pick up black folks, that's your decision. But don't try and make it out to be some kind of race thing and I'm some kind of Uncle Tom, because I'm not. What y'all worried about being politically correct? Yeah. Fuck politically. I take care of myself. You ain't gonna take care of me.
No.
Neither is nobody else. Now, if y'all want to stay down there on the south side of Chicago and drive up and down between 35th and 95th all day and night long, that's totally up to you. But don't you tell me how to do my business.
Man, come on. White folk rob cab drivers, too.
Well, I got to pick up somebody.
I swear to God.
What the fuck you know about Malcolm X? What the fuck you know about being black? You can all the time be whining about how you feel sorry for black people. Be like, oh, I feel so sorry for the poor black man. But the truth of the matter is, at the end of the day, you are a white man going home in your white skin, and I am a black man going home in my black skin in America, so don't you tell me you know anything about it, because you don't know shit.
Flying's moving.
Oh, yeah. Looks like they got luggage, too. Well, let's hope they're going to O'Hare and not the goddamn Northwestern train station, huh?
I am so tired.
It's a free country.
Taxi!
Hey, morning, do you?
Northwestern train station, please.
You got it.
Oh, it got awful cold this morning, didn't it?
Hey, sure did. And the weatherman said snow, possibly.
Oh, well, what's a Christmas without snow?
Hey, exactly. Hey. So, how you doing?
Oh, fine, I guess. I still have a lot of shopping to do.
Time's running out.
Hey, I know.
So, what do you do?
I'm a lawyer.
Oh, really?
You got something against lawyers?
Well, yeah, sure. Doesn't everybody? I mean, oh, let's face it. When it comes to your profession, it's just a big bag of... No, never mind.
What?
No, forget
No, I want to hear this. What is it about lawyers that you don't particularly like?
Well, the fact that they're all sharks.
And why do you say that? Do you know any lawyers?
Hey, you ever seen a TV show called Court TV? It's got its own cable network station, and all they show 24 hours a day is current trials. Mostly the sensational stuff. Hey, you ought to get a look at the lawyers on that show, boy, and curl your hair.
Well, if you're talking about criminal attorneys.
Yeah, criminal
attorneys. It's pretty well known that the worst lawyers are the criminal attorneys.
Well, get out of here.
No, I'm serious. They become criminal attorneys because, well, they're usually not smart enough to do anything else.
Oh, what? They teach you that in law school?
It's pretty well known in the profession.
Hey, you trying to yank my chain here?
No.
I may be a taxi driver, but I'm not stupid.
I didn't say that you were.
Well, you can't go making a gross generalization like all criminal attorneys aren't as smart as the rest of the profession. I didn't just fall off the cabbage truck.
Now, hold on a second. I wasn't insinuating that you had.
Hey, you tell me, what other profession has public humiliation as an integral part of its system?
And how is that?
You're a woman. You ever seen a lawyer get a woman who claims she's been raped up on a witness stand? Asking her all these questions like, hey, how many men you sleep with? How many times? Going into every little detail. Man, That is disgusting.
You can't do that anymore. They have passed laws against that kind of cross-examination.
See, that's exactly it. It was so rampant they had to pass a law to keep a lawyer's integrity in check.
But that goes back to the criminal attorneys. See, it's the criminal attorneys who do that.
All right. I take it back. Lawyers aren't sharks. That's too high up on the evolutionary platform. Lawyers are, they're cockroaches.
Oh, just let me out on the corner, please.
But before or after the light?
Before.
That's $4. Hey, I hope I didn't offend you.
Oh, no.
We could continue this discussion over dinner if you'd like. I'm a stud.
Hey! Cool. Take me to Water Tower.
The shopping center or the tourist attraction?
Funny, the mall.
Okay.
Son of a bitch.
What's the matter?
My car won't start. I'm having car trouble today. And I'm late.
Well, what's wrong with the car?
It won't start. What do you mean, what's wrong with the car?
Well, you know, I thought if it's just the battery, I'll go and jump it.
Listen, I don't know what's wrong with the car, and I don't want to talk about it, okay? I don't want to have any, like, conversation here. I just want you to take me to Water Tower, right?
Okay.
Fine.
Having the real Christmas spirit. Boy, she only knew. She only knew. If she only knew what a fucking lousy, rip-roaring, cock-sucking bitch she was. Yeah, Christmas time, too. Yeah, like Christmas isn't fucked up as it is, I gotta have some cunt treating me like I was her fucking spittoon. God damn it. Fucking people make me sick.
Don't!
Hey! You guys call the man?
I'm paying in advance, man. Paying in advance. Don't think we're gonna run out on you, man. We ain't gonna run out on you, man. We ain't gonna run out on you. We pay everything, man. We pay up. So just don't get any ideas like we're gonna run out on you or anything, man.
Hey, don't worry about it. Just tell me where you wanna go.
I'm going to a little grocery store about 5 blocks from here, man. You don't mind if I drink a beer in your car, do you, man?
Shit.
Yeah, we're going to a little grocery store about 2 blocks from here, man. Just go down to the light and hang left.
Okay.
This fucking rock is kicking my ass.
Man.
That was some good shit.
Mm-hmm.
Richard said if we can come up with the dough, he'll come up with the shit.
Yeah.
We can come up with the dough, man. Fuck yeah, we can come up with the dough. Coming up with the dough's the easy part, man. Coming up with the fucking dough's the easy part.
Yeah.
You got any cash on you, man?
No.
What do you mean, no? I'm gonna do everything I fucking sell? Man, give me those food stamps,
all right, ma'am, and I ain't gonna give you all of them, all right?
Just give me the fucking food stamps. And what about the $7? I thought you said you had $7.
Yeah, I know, man. I gotta buy a pair of pants.
Man, fuck your pair of pants.
Man, if I don't come home with a pair of pants, my old man's gonna kill me,
man,
all right?
Man, fuck your old man. Do you wanna do this rock
man,
or not, huh, honey?
I gotta have my pants.
Hey, man, pull up here, man. Pull up here. Holy shit. 2 seconds.
Jesus Christ.
He wouldn't do it.
What?
He wouldn't do it. Motherfucker!
Damn it.
He'd do it if I was a chick. If I was a chick, he'd do it.
Oh, no!
He does it all the time in that fucking gas! Okay, man. We gotta try someplace else. Just go down here. Just take a left on California. Go down about 2 blocks, man.
You know, shouldn't say that about my old man.
What?
shouldn't say shit about my old man, all right?
Man, fuck your old
See,
man.
See, I tell you, my man.
I said, fuck your old man. And fuck your pair of pants, too. I'm trying to score some fucking rockin'. I gotta hear about that fucking old... What the fuck?
Holy fucking shit. It's Homer, man.
Stop the car, man. I'll be back in a second. Just stop the car. Don't fuck me.
Ugh. This guy's a fucking nut.
What?
This guy's a fucking nut.
Oh, yeah.
Been acting all crazy and shit, man, you know.
Yeah.
It's wrong.
Hey, is this guy a friend of yours?
Man, I met him about an hour ago. You know that bar you picked us up at?
What?
Yeah. I don't know this other guy in the news.
You don't?
You're gonna get shot in the car!
How much money you got, Homer?
Well, about $5.
Oh, $5 and ain't shit, man. You got any food stamps, man? Hand them over. You give me yours, too. Come on.
Come on, man.
Let's go. The fuck off. Count up this shit. Man, driving, man, can you turn down the heat, man? I'm sweating my ass off in here, man. It's hot as a motherfucker in here, man, and I'm in this motherfucking t-shirt, man. You know, this motherfucking t-shirt, man. What about it? This would you count that fucking shit off?
Here's the beer, man. Two.
I'm feeling good, man. My heart is pumping, man. What about it, Homer? What about it, man? Are we kicking some ass or what? Oh, shit, driver, man. If we go over the meter, if we go over $4, you'll take food stamps, right?
Yeah. Yeah.
What?
They're just like cash, man. Damn, they're just as fucking good as... Oh, shit. The place is closed. Okay, we gotta try someplace else, man. Just, just take me to us. It's Sacramento and... Homer, man, what the fuck? Sacramento and Jimmy...
Oh, I don't know, man.
Just take me to Sacramento and what the fuck? Sacramento and what the fuck?
You said what the fuck,
what the fuck? Shut the fuck up. Just drive to Sacramento, man. I'll tell you when I stop.
What the fuck? I don't mean to alarm anybody, but we're already over $4.
We're over $4.
Well, we just gotta get it straightened out.
What's the problem, man?
There isn't any problem.
Don't you wanna fucking take me around?
Yeah, sure. No problem. No problem. You just tell me where you wanna go.
Just turn right up here, man. Turn right up here and go down about 2 blocks. Fuck this.
Here.
I wanna go to the man. Go straight to the man. He owes me. He owes me. He owes me a little money. He owes me a little money, and I know he ain't working, so I know he ain't home. Or he is home. Or not.
No.
He might not be, man. He might not be home. He might be out. He might be out looking for a fucking job or something, man.
No.
Or he could be home.
Yeah. Hi.
He might be. You never know. Just pull up here, man. Just fucking pull up. Here. I'll be right back.
Hey, I'm going with him.
Fuck me. Something else, huh?
Yeah.
Hey, man, you know, he's just like all cooked up. That's all, right?
Yeah. Hey, lady.
What?
Look, I got nothing against you, you understand?
Yeah.
But this guy is scaring me. He's acting all wild and shit, and I don't like it. It's scaring me, so I'm gonna have to ask you to take a hike.
Sorry.
It's nothing against you, you understand that?
No.
It's just, hey, this guy is...
I understand, but...
Fuck out!
Detective!
Afternoon.
That's fine. I'll need to go over there to that used car lot on 65th and Ashland.
Okay.
Damn, it's as cold as a motherfucker.
Well, yeah, it's Chicago. But it's winter. It's gonna get cold, I guess. You gonna go buy a car?
No, I gotta go talk to the owner of the lot.
Yeah?
Yeah. The motherfucker be fucking me around, I think. Well, I hope not. Shit, better not be.
Well, what happened?
I was on that lot 2 days ago. And I bought me an 88 Honda Civic. Straight off the lot. Paid for the motherfucker in cash. I asked him what kind of warranty I'm gonna give in case this motherfucker break down on me, right? Mm-hmm. He said he'd fix it, anything go wrong with it in 2 months. Well, I had it out yesterday and I was driving it, and the motherfucking engine blew up on me. Oh, so I called him back this morning because he towed it in. He said he's gonna take a look at it. Now it's gonna cost me for the tow, and ain't gonna fix it for nothing. Oh, no, no. See, now it's gonna cost me $800. Well, I ain't got $800, and even if I did, I wouldn't be giving it to him nohow.
Oh, well, hey, did you sign a contract or anything?
Signed the contract.
Well, man, I don't know if you got a leg to stand on, because if you don't have proof that you went in there and bought
the motherfucker shook my hand. Then he said I ain't gonna work in a car unless I get $50 for the tow. I ain't got that kind of money. I just spent $2,000 on a motherfucking car. Hey.
Well, what are you gonna do?
I'll tell you what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna go in there, I'm gonna explain to him I said he's gonna fix my car. I'm gonna remind him. Motherfucking Arab ain't got no business belonging in this country nohow. Am I right or wrong? I'm just gonna explain to him how he either owes me a free fix or a new motherfucking car.
Don't touch me.
Sorry, man.
Well, hey, what if he says no?
He ain't gonna say no. We had a deal. You know what I'm saying? And if he does say no, I got a friend. I ain't saying nothing like we gonna fuck him up or anything like that. You know what I'm saying? But if he don't do right by me, he's gonna be awful motherfucking sorry, because I got a friend.
Well, hey, man, be careful. You don't want to go to jail because of this asshole.
Oh, shit, he ain't gonna call no police.
You sure?
Hell no. He ain't gonna call no police.
Afternoon. Or is it still morning?
I'm going to my apartment on State and Harrison.
Okay.
So, are you gonna call me Mama, or are you gonna call me Sugar Mama? You are gonna call me Sugar Mama, aren't you?
What?
Are you gonna call me Mama, or are you gonna call me Sugar Mama? If you are gonna call me Mama, you better hurry up, so go ahead.
You don't
have to be shy.
I'm not.
That's good, you may proceed. Go ahead and say, hello, Mama. I have come to tell you all my troubles.
Wait a minute.
Put your head on my chest and
say... Hey, wait a minute.
What?
I can't call you Mama. You're not old enough to be my mother.
Flattery will get you everywhere. But, in fact, I am old enough to be your Mama. If I started out at a young age, which I did... Well, probably not that young, though. Not for lack of trying. How old do you think I am?
Oh, you know, I don't...
Come on, take it.
You're, 40? No, 42.
Oh, you are sweet. You are a real sweet boy. You must be trying to get on my good side.
Ah, well.
Keep it up. You are doing real good.
Well, what do you do?
You mean for a job?
Yeah.
I'm a lawyer.
Really? You're the second lawyer I had today.
Really? Let's hope you're not too tired.
Excuse me?
I'm a contract lawyer and I hate it. It's boring as hell. The only way that I can get through all those meetings is by thinking about sex all the time.
Well, isn't that nice?
But enough about me. Where are you from?
Rockford, originally.
So what brings you to Chicago?
I couldn't find a job in Rockford.
So you drive a cab.
I can't find a job in Chicago either.
I was in Rockford once.
Really? It's a beautiful little town.
I wouldn't know. I spent most of the time in a motel room.
Oh, yeah? Like, you mean conducting job interviews and such?
Oh, you are a funny guy. This is good. Pull over here.
Well, you're a very sexy woman. But I guess you know that, though, don't you?
So I've been told.
That's 370. Republicans? What is that? Hey, geez, what is that? Oh, boy. Oh, man. You gonna call me Mama? You gonna call me Sugar Mama? Hungry. I'll call you Hungry. How about that? Call you. Hey, yeah, I got it. You gonna call me Whopper? Or are you gonna call me Big Mac? Hey, if you're gonna call me Big Mac, you better hurry up. I might just take a bite out of you. That's nuts. That is nutty nuts. Hey, give me a break. Weirdos don't come out until late. What am I saying? They're here. That's great. Welcome to hell. I hate this motherfucking job. I drive a cab for Satan. Hellcab. Okay.
Could you do me a small favor? Mm. Could you wait here just 1 minute, please?
Mm-hmm.
Appreciate it.
Could you take us to the Days Inn on Diversity?
Okay.
Thanks.
Oh,
shaking. Did you bring the bananas? I can smell it. I can smell you. I gotta have you. I gotta have you right here. Right now.
Oh, hey, man, what are you doing?
Turn around, no, driver, man. This is none of your business. No
boy.
No tea.
Okay. Hey, you mind if I smoke? Hey, so is that Michael Jordan a god or what?
Hey! Oh! All right. Almost missed us.
Oh, yeah, I just caught you out of the corner of my eye. It's a hell of a whistle, let me tell you. Is that yours, man?
Yeah. Well, my father taught me when I was a kid.
Oh, well, I'm impressed.
Thanks.
All right, we're making two stops. First, we're taking her to the California Pizza office at Franklin and Erie. Then we're going to my apartment at 900 North Michigan. You think you can handle that, sport?
Sure can.
Good. So, do you like the ski?
Yeah.
Really, where do you go?
It's been a long time since
We should go sometime.
Yeah?
Sure. What about Vail? You ever been to
Vail?
Oh, Vail. Vail is absolutely beautiful, especially this time of year. Oh. Kind of touristy, but you get that, you know? Hey, speaking of beautiful, you are absolutely beautiful. You know that? No, really, I mean it. Oh, I see. You get that all the time, right?
No.
Oh, come on. You do, too.
I do not.
You should call me.
I'll call you.
You should call me more often. Hey, driver, this is good here.
Bye.
Bye.
All right, now don't be a stranger, huh?
Okay.
I'm serious about Vail.
All right.
Okay.
Bye.
Bye.
Thanks
for a lot. Oh. Bye. Man, she's good looking.
Yeah, she sure is.
And, she seems like a real nice person, too.
Yeah.
She your girlfriend?
Oh, no, it's just some chick I keep around to fuck every now and then.
Oh.
Oh, yeah, she's a receptionist, you know, so whenever I'm in town, I like to give her a call so I can poke her.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, I run a chain of delicatessens downstate. Steve's Deli. That's me. I'm Steve. I probably never heard of us, seeing as how we're mainly in the college towns downstate. I do have a store up in Evanston, though. Yeah, I'll tell you what. I started this business back when I was in college. 10 years later, I got 6 stores. I am making money hand over fist. Yeah, we're open breakfast, lunch, dinner. Then we keep it open late at night to catch the college kids coming in drunk for a little late night snack, you know. So basically, we end up fleecing them 4 times a day. Hey, man, why don't you go?
I can't. I got this old woman in front of my car.
Goddamn nigger bitch. She wonders why she can't get a job, huh? shit. Hey, took a vacation a while back. Yeah, went to Paris. I tell you, man, I get tired, you know? When you're the boss, you're responsible for everything. You know, something goes wrong, it's up to you to clean up after whoever fucked it up. This is good here. I want to get a paper.
That's $4.50.
All right. Keep the change, sport.
So the light turns green, but we're not going anywhere because I got this old black woman in front of my car. You got me, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, and so he goes, hey, why ain't we going? And I point to the old woman, and he goes, goddamn nigger bitch. Mm. And she wonders why she can't get a job.
Sounds like a class A jerk, if you ask me.
Oh, man, and all the rest of the ride, he's going on and on about what a hotshot businessman he is.
Yeah.
How he's making money hand over fist, like he's at the top of this kind of ladder, and he spits down on all the rest of us here in the heat. Boy, that pisses me off.
Hey, I know.
But what really pisses me off is what he said about that woman. Ah, man, how do people get like that? You should have seen him. He was talking so sweet to her, and she, man, she was eating it up.
Women.
So, what do I do?
Nothing you can do.
Well, I can tell her. I know where she works.
Don't do it.
Why not?
Look, she's probably getting what she wants off the guy, and as long as he keeps spending the money, who cares what he says behind her back?
No, I just don't think she was like that.
When did this happen?
About 10 minutes ago.
Well, you can do what you want to do, but don't be surprised if you don't get the reaction you're expecting.
Hi. You remember me?
Yeah.
I'm the cab driver. I just dropped
you.
I have to tell you something. But let me start out by saying this. I don't want anything from you. I'm going to say what I have to say, and then I'm going out that door, and you are never going to see me again. You got that?
What is it?
Because I don't want anything from you. You understand that, don't you? Because I don't.
Right.
But I came back here because I wanted you to know that that guy you were with today, just now,
uh-huh.
in the cab.
Yeah.
Well, that guy's a real asshole.
Well, what happened?
Do you know what he said about you? Do you know what he said?
No.
Well, I said, you seem like a real nice person. And he said, oh, that's just some little chicky I keep around to fuck every now and then.
Oh, come on. He did?
Yeah. And I'm sorry, but I had to tell you. I mean, you seem like you're a nice person, or you could be a nice person, and that guy's a real asshole.
Yeah, well, you know, we're not dating or anything. I mean, we're not seeing each other. We just had lunch today, and that's all, okay?
All right, right. I know. And it's none of my business, because it's not. And it isn't.
No.
But I felt like if you were seeing him, or if you were thinking about going out with him or something, which is, you know, I mean to say it's none of my business, but the guy's a fucking asshole.
Oh,
that's all I wanted to say. I mean, it's bad enough, it being Christmas time and all, and if you're all alone, it's damn hard. I know it is. Not that I'm saying you're all alone. I'm just saying that I know how it is, and it's bad.
Can you take me to the corner of Division and Wells?
That's fine by me.
Some weather we're having, huh?
Yeah, Yeah. Cold as hell.
Weatherman says it's supposed to get warmer by the weekend.
Is that so?
Yeah. Hey, man. You know what this country needs?
Oh, what's that, man?
This country is lost, right? This country's lost its way. Am I right about this?
Yeah.
So what is it that we need? What do we need to focus our energies on to get this country back on track, hmm?
What?
In a word, space exploration.
Oh, jeez.
Do you realize how many tons of minerals there are up there on the moon? Huh? What, did you just think it was made out of cheese? No! There are tons and tons of minerals up there. There's enough minerals up there to meet our energy needs until the sun burns out. It's cheap, it doesn't pollute, and all we have to do is go up there and get it.
But it's on the moon.
Oh, what if it's on the moon? Oh, would that have stopped George Washington, huh? No, this country was built on can-do, not can't-do. Why do you think everyone's jealous of the American spirit, huh? It's because we take adversity and we spit in its eye. We roll up our sleeves until we get the job done.
Yeah, I guess you're right.
Hell yeah, I'm right. Space exploration, it's the wave of the future. This is good here.
That's 220.
Hey, man. So what does this country need, huh?
Space exploration.
Right! Oh, hey, look. A funeral. Going to the boneyard! Going to the boneyard!
Evening.
Hey.
Or is it still afternoon?
Yeah, it's dark pretty early, don't.
Oh, thanks for waiting. Hey, could you take us to the south side?
Bridgeport, I hope.
3505 South Kedzie?
Yeah, okay.
Oh, thanks. Hey, so how's it going? Are you making a living?
I'm trying to. Yeah. You know, it's a little slow right now. It's the holidays. People getting off work, going on vacation, all that.
Oh, hey, you use that Gandalf much?
What, you a cab driver?
Oh, no, my brother is. He drives for Yellow. You know, you can probably use that thing to get yourself a ride back downtown.
No, I don't use it that much anymore.
Huh?
A lot of times it just takes me too far away from the areas I know,
yeah. And
I get lost. You know, I've been thinking a lot lately about just getting rid of it.
So what's the matter with you, huh?
Like, you don't know.
Oh, what, so now I'm supposed to be a mind reader, huh? Is that it? Oh, yeah, so now I'm a fucking mind reader, huh? Like that fucking jag-off on Carson when Carson was on, the amazing fucking what's-his-name? Oh, so now I'm the amazing fucking what's-his-name,
right? Listen, I don't want to talk about it, okay?
All right, fine. How about them bulls? They killing them or what?
Well, they're doing fine. I just hope they don't get tired and hurt.
Hey, you know, just wait till the playoffs. Then they turn around.
They're tired,
right,
man. They spent the summer in Carson.
Don't give me this shit, huh? Just tell me what I did. What did I do?
Okay, I heard what you said at Mary's party last night.
What did I say?
So I don't want to talk about it, because I can't believe it. No.
What?
Standing around with Tony and Billy and that asshole Jim Corelli, right? Yeah, and Corelli says to you, yeah, Brenda used to fuck everybody on the block. She was all the time just fucking everybody on the block. And what did you say?
Look, you're taking the whole conversation entirely out of context.
Well, I am, huh? And what did you say? You say, yeah, she's probably fucking everybody on the block now.
It was a joke.
You're my boyfriend. I mean, you're supposed to defend me or something.
Well, you were fucking everyone on the block.
Oh, man, fuck you. Fuck you.
You. You were?
Oh, if that bothers you so goddamn much, then why did you ever ask me out in the first place, huh? I mean, you knew who I was, right? You know what I've done. I mean, why did you ever ask me out if you think that I'm such a slut, huh?
Linda, it's just the way guys talk.
No.
If you was a guy, you'd understand. It's just the way we talk.
I can't believe I know you. I mean, I can't believe I associate with you. Oh, excuse
my life.
Kinda.
Driving on the south side. This is the south side. The south side of Chicago. Southeast side to be exact. Fuck that. I'm going north.
Tell you when we get there.
Well, is it past division? Say.
Just keep going.
Yeah, but I need to know where we're going.
I told you. Up the street.
Yeah, but I need to know how far we're going. See, I told somebody I'd pick him up in 15 minutes, so I can't be going too far.
It's past division.
How far? How far past division is it?
It's past division. About 4 blocks.
So it's up by North Avenue. It's up by North?
You make a left here.
I thought you said it was up by North.
Make a left here.
Okay. Dark street. We getting close to where you want to be?
Just keep going.
Couple of blocks?
Just keep going.
Yeah, all right, I'll keep going. I don't know where you want me to be.
Make a left into the alley.
I don't want to.
Make a left into the alley.
I gotta be back pretty soon. I told him I'd pick him up in 15 minutes. Here? $4.
Merry Christmas.
Yeah, and to you.
Truman College.
Yeah, okay.
I've been drinking.
I know.
Ah, fuck it. It's Christmas. Can I have a drink if I want?
No law against it.
Oh, no. I saw my old man today.
Yeah, your husband?
Father, I asked him for some money. He gave it to me that time. I'm on welfare.
Oh.
Money can get pretty tight.
Boy, I know it can.
Say, what's your name, pal? I like you. You're a good guy. That old fat son of a bitch, all he ever does is sit around all day. Fuck him! I hate him! Oh, I really appreciate you picking me up.
No problem.
You know, you're a good guy. You know that? Are you married?
No.
Well, you ought to be. Say, why don't you come and have a few drinks with me? I'm buying.
I'd love to, but I gotta work. You know how it is.
No, I'm on welfare. Hey, you know, you are pretty nice looking too.
Thanks.
Yeah, I really appreciate you picking me up. You remind me of a guy I went out with in junior high, Kevin Shaw. Oh, Kevin, say, you don't mind if I call you Kevin, do ya?
Yeah, don't call me Kevin. It's not my name.
Okay. Don't get sore. I love you. You know that?
That's great.
I know I do love you, and I am gonna give you $10 for this fare because I love you.
Well, whatever.
I do love you. I love you very much. I wish that you were my boyfriend.
Well, you know, you can't have everything.
I love you.
Hey, what are you touching me for?
Well, you don't have to get mad.
I just don't like people touching me. A guy was touching me earlier today, a fucking guy. I just don't like it. It just bugs the shit out of me.
Are you a homo?
You know, I'm just taking you to the wooden nickel lounge. That's all I'm doing. And I'm not like this guy you knew in junior high school either. I'm not like him at all. I'm not him at all. Do you understand that?
Yeah, I understand that. What do you think? I'm stupid or something?
I didn't say that.
I love you.
No! Thanks!
China Club.
I swear I don't even know where the fuck we are.
Shut the fuck up, man. You're drunk.
Oh, man. Hey, man, look. That guy's got a Cubby's hat on. Hey!
Hey,
come stop! Come stop! Stop!
Hey, you guys from out of town?
Yeah, we're from New York.
Oh, boy, I never would have guessed.
Yeah, man, our sports teams beat the hell out of your sports teams. Right. And do you know why, man?
Oh, you're going to tell me why, aren't
you? Yeah, it's because Chicago sucks.
That's right, man. New York's great, and Chicago sucks.
Yeah, we're great, and you guys suck. And all your sports teams are a bunch of pussies, man.
Hey, when was the last time the Cubbies cooked the series, huh? 1900?
1908, I believe.
You see, you guys blow.
Jeez. What about the Bulls?
Oh, what about them,
man, huh? Michael Jordan is a 6'6", bald-headed faggot.
Hey, man, leave Michael out of this.
Well, what, man?
Or I'm gonna cry.
Oh, shit, you're gonna cry. You're cool, man.
Hey,
man, why don't you come to the China Club with us, man? It's gonna be great.
Nah, I have to work.
Oh, come on, man. We're gonna go get some pussy.
Go on, man. Take a little break.
No, I can't. I have to work.
Oh, well.
Hey, there's another one. Hey,
come stop,
stop, stop, stop.
Oh, what the hell, one last one.
I'm only going about 3 blocks from here. Take a right on Berwyn and then take the first left.
Okay.
Sorry. Did you call the police?
Yeah. Yeah, what do you think that this is?
Oh, I'm so sorry. Did you know the guy?
Yeah. I'm gonna kill him. I'm gonna kill the son of a bitch. Have you ever been raped?
No.
It's bad.
Hey, are you all right?
No, I'm not all right.
Do you want me to take you to the hospital?
No. I don't have any insurance anyway.
Why didn't the police take you home?
I don't know. I didn't do anything.
I know, ma'am. I am so sorry. I wish it hadn't happened to you, ma'am. I am so sorry.
You don't have to apologize. You didn't do anything.
I know, but I'm sorry anyway.
This is my house.
$220. Hey, I'll stay out here till you get inside.
Oh. Hey, how you doing?
Where you wanna go?
Oh, all right. I'm just going down the street about three blocks. This little diner on Melrose and Broadway. I'm gonna pick up some food and come right back here. You don't mind waiting, do you?
No.
So how was your day?
I'm really tired. I've been working all day.
Yeah, me too. I'm just gonna have this late dinner and get right back to it.
What do you do?
I'm an architect.
That's cool.
It can be. You know, sometimes. Sleigh bells ring, are you listening? In the lane, snow is glistening. Beautiful sight, we're happy tonight. Walking in a winter wonderland. In the meadow, we can build a snowman. And pretend that he is Possum Brown. He'll ask us all we met.
You know, you're in a good mood.
Yeah, I guess I am. I guess so.
Must be nice.
It can be. It can be.
That's a good way to be during the holidays.
Yeah. You can't count on it, though, can you? You can let me out right here on the corner. I called ahead so it shouldn't take too long. I really appreciate it, man. Thanks a lot.
I'll be here. Hey, where the hell am I going? God, that poor woman. Hey, why does everything have to be so fucked up? I just don't get it. Why do I wish I could just crawl out of my skin? I live in a desert. Ah, Jesus, there was nothing I could do about it. Since when can I ever do anything about anything at all, huh?
Oh, all righty. You can just take me back to where you found me.
Yeah, will do. It's gonna take me a little while longer to get back there, though, because of the one-way street.
Oh, that's no problem.
Well, I just didn't want you to think I was jacking up the fare.
Man, I wasn't gonna think that. Come on. Oh, Tannenbaum.
cannonball.
Are you going home for Christmas?
Me? No. No, not this year.
I am. Oh, I'm going to Rockford.
It's going to be a tough one for me this year. Christmas, I mean. It'll be the first one I've ever spent without my mom.
Oh.
She passed away last year.
I'm sorry.
You know, what are you going to do? I mean, she was a good woman. She led a good life. You know what I'm saying? And I'm going to miss her terribly, though. The holidays are always the hardest time, as you could probably imagine.
Yeah.
Your folks still alive?
Mine?
Yeah.
Yeah.
You're a lucky man.
The last year, my ma called me and told me she found a lump in her breast. And then, when the test results came back, the results were inconclusive. And then right in the middle of it all, you know, the doctor had to go out of town for a week. So it was just taking that much longer. And man, I thought I was going to have a nervous breakdown.
Is she okay?
It was benign. But, you know, all the same, I kept asking myself, you know, what if it hadn't been? Because there was nothing I could do, you know? Everything. It all comes out of nowhere, you know? Like one day everything is fine, and then the next day you don't know if your mom's gonna die.
Yeah, you feel helpless, huh?
Yeah. Like this woman I just picked up. She had just been raped. Just now. And there was nothing. There was nothing I could do for her. You know, I mean, I could tell her how sorry I was for her and everything, but I couldn't do anything for her. I mean, I couldn't even tell her I knew it was going to be all right, because I knew it wasn't going to be all right. And it wasn't.
Well, there isn't anything you could have done for her, man.
I know, but I wish I could have.
But you couldn't.
You know, I kept telling her over and over again how sorry I was.
Well, what more could you do? I don't understand you.
Hey, nothing. I mean, that's it. That's the point. God damn it.
You probably did a lot for her just by being here in that moment.
That's not enough, though. It's never enough.
When my mom got sick, we didn't know what it was. One day I went into a hospital room and we were chatting. And she looks over at me and she goes, well, it looks like it's the big C. By the time the doctors had gotten to it, it was inoperable. My mother hated doctors, so for the next few months it was her coming in and going out and coming in and going out until finally she died. But now all I could do was love her. In the moments when she was awake, when she realized who I was, all I could do was give her my love. That's all any of us can do. That's all we can give.
I kept that woman's money. Her fare was $2.20, and she gave me $4, and I kept it. And I could have let her have it.
You're a cab driver.
I'm sorry. You gotta get back to work. That's $4.
Now you keep that for yourself.
No, I can't.
Sure you can. It's Christmas.
Oh, hi, I know. Come on.
Man. Come on, please. Hey, please. God damn. Come on, do me a favor. All right?
Well, hey, Merry Christmas to you.
Merry Christmas to you.
Thank you.
Brandy.